too?
Yes, it really is.
Unless you're deep in the field.
Here come a large pack of frontrunners. Trouble off the corner.
31.
Several cars involved. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Sterling Marlin, Mike Skinner, Jeff Gordon's in it. Bobby Hamilton, Kurt Busch is in the crash. Dale Jarrett takes to the pit road. Terry Labonte's involved. Caution's out.
I didn't see it, but it looked like some guys were trying to get in the pits, and it just stacked up.
See some damage to the right front of Kevin Harvick's car. Not a lot of damage, but damage. Oh, a lot of damage to that automobile.
Ran so well earlier in the night. There's Skinner. Mike gets the fence. Mike's moving around. Looks like he's okay. Jeff Gordon and Kevin Harvick took their cars straight to pit road. But it all happened behind Dale Earnhardt Jr.
Bobby Hamilton trying to push his car back, backwards down pit road.
That car will go behind the wall. We talked about the big wreck. This one happened in a way we didn't expect.
A lot of damage to Terry Labonte's car.
All right, let's see if we can sort this one out.
All right, here they're coming off the corner. And I think it's going to be contact right there. Skinner and Kurt Busch get together. Turn Skinner into the wall head on. Labonte has no place to go. Neither does Bobby Hamilton when Skinner comes back across the racetrack. Now there's no place for anybody to go.
Ooh, oh, was that the just stuck by? Nemechek.
Nemechek, yeah.
And Dave John Marcus, Andretti.
Dave Marcus gets out on the grass and somehow saves it.
He's almost as good as you.
I know.
And you know what? The 7 car was slowing down, coming in the pits. 31 checked up, 97 ran into him.
Yep. Shot right across in front of Terry Labonte. Watch the back of this. Dale Jarrett, top right of your screen, going to come through the smoke, head for pit road.
There's a lot of wrecking going on there, Dale. I'd be careful on pit road if I were you. The racetrack looked to be the safest place. You ever see Kurt Busch right on the back bumper, and Mike Wallace goes toward pit road. There's the contact. Skinner gets turned. And, man, Terry Labonte says, oh, no.
Is that Mark Martin piling in there? Mark has continued driving around. But his chance at that million-dollar bonus appears to have taken a little bit of a hit there if the damage is significant on his car. Was that Mark's car?
Another shot.
Get a better look at it here.
And it just doesn't take much. I mean, you know, Mike saw the 7 car coming in the pits. He rolled out a little bit. Busch couldn't see what was going on. It just doesn't take much.
There we saw the contact with Jeff Gordon. Listen to this, folks.
Can do on that. All those guys behind had nowhere to go. They're up there minding their own business. And
Sterling Marlin.
That's going to leave a mark.
Oh, man, I felt that. Did you feel that?
I did feel that. That's because you hit me when it happened.
Ricky Rudd, lucky man.
Jeff Gordon, let's see him down there. He makes contact with Sterling Marlin. And the 97 car makes contact with Jeff. Oh. He goes down through the grass.
I mean, Nemechek. Nemechek. Pit road is closed because a number of the cars involved in the accident crashing down onto the pit entry. They want to make sure they've got all the metal picked up and other debris. So we'll take a break and come back for the caution flag pit stops in just a moment. Only 16 laps to go in the Pepsi 400 at Daytona.
Welcome back to Daytona. Pit stops that could decide the race. Dale Earnhardt Jr., the leader, is in. Much debate about 2 or 4 tires. They decided to go the safe route with 4 tires, and they will still win the race off pit road, barely beating Mike Wallace.
Nice job, guys.
see what NASCAR has to say about that. You see that white line right in front of Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s pit. All he has to do is bump the clutch and get the car across that line.
That was close.
And that locks in his position in the pit exit order. So we'll see what they where they position people from that.
I don't know if the 7 took 4 or 2 tires on that stop.
Had to be 2.
Yeah. Yeah.
Had to be 2.
Yeah. The 4 tires, that's the right move.
Jeff Gordon still getting attention. One of the 7 cars involved in the wreck just a moment ago off turn 4.
Kevin Harvick, we saw the damage on the right front. They're trying to put a piece of aluminum over that.
Now, let's see. Look at the white line coming out of pit road off the pit stops. That line. Who got there first?
I don't know. That's... I couldn't tell. Did you, Benny?
Nope. Up for NASCAR to decide. That's why they get the big bucks.
So Mike Wallace, for now, defending his position in front of Dale Earnhardt Jr. on the track, but Jr. trying to drop the hint that he thinks maybe he got out first. Seen this on many, well, now.
Yep, he was just told.
He was told by his team. I didn't hear NASCAR tell him.
Here comes Mike back.
I didn't hear NASCAR. But the big winners in all this are the orange car and the green car right there. Bobby Labonte in the green car and Tony Stewart in the orange machine.
They have made their pit stop. They just changed 2 tires, but they have that track position they've been looking for all night long.
Here are the cars involved in the crash, adding Jason Leffler to the list that we gave you earlier. Mark Martin, one of the Noble 5 drivers with the shot at the $1 million bonus tonight. All triggered with Kurt Busch into the back of Mike Skinner as Mike Wallace slowed to get to pit road. Dave Burns.
Well, and Alan, Sterling Marlin is helping orchestrate whatever fixes they might make here. Sterling, do you think you can make fixes at all here and get back in?
I don't know. Broke something on the steering. I didn't have any steering. And couldn't turn a layoff. Something broke somewhere. But I hate if all the cars like guys. We had a pretty good car. Just tight, loose at times. I don't know what happened. I might have got in somebody.
What was the first reaction you had? Did your spotter didn't even have time to tell anything, did you?
No, it looked to me like Skinner cut somebody off to get in a pits and turn it sideways. And went nowhere for us to go. But... that's what you get with these rules. Everybody's on top of each other. And I pray the good Lord they change these rules. Just keep racing.
All right, strong opinion from Sterling Marlin on the aerodynamic rules that they have in the cars here, as well as the restrictor plate racing. Alan?
Sterling Marlin, 5th in the championship coming into this race. He'll take a big hit in points tonight. 14 laps to go at Daytona. Sure, he'd love to see Michael Waltrip or Steve Park somewhere close to him. Michael's back in 14th and Park is in 22nd.
I don't think Dale needs anybody.
All right, get all the gears.
7 laps left. Now it'll be 6 as they come to the start-finish line. Time to settle the Pepsi 400 at Daytona. Dale Earnhardt Jr. is 6th in line and Benson leads on restart.
Once again, you can't pass on the inside. You get to that line. All right, free game. Let's go.
Ward Burton quickly down to the inside to try and grab a spot.
Jeff Gordon back on the racetrack. Earnhardt Jr. lying back, trying to get him a run. He has that run, but Tony Stewart pulls up in front of him. He's got Jeremy Mayfield.
He's got time, I guess.
Schrader pushed to the outside lane.
20 cars, the only one upstairs. Still outside.
Look at Jr.
There,
go.
Up to 4th. Here comes Bobby Labonte pushing through. Junior to the outside of Mayfield for 3rd.
7th coming with you. 7th coming.
Mike Wallace is coming with him. We can hear Ty Norris telling him, you got help on the outside, Junior.
There's Blaney block in the 93. What about Benson?
They're going to stay on the bottom of the racetrack. I think they're going to give the outside to Junior.
Gordon getting black flagged by NASCAR.
Still there.
Here
outside of Dave Blaney for second spot. Mayfield pushes him along in the draft.
Still there, still there.
To the outside for the lead in turn four.
Still
Dale Earnhardt Jr.
Still
rockets
there.
To the front
still
of Daytona.
There.
Listen to the crowd.
And look at this crowd
here,
behind
here,
it. Look at this race
here.
Behind it. And Tony Stewart gets run underneath the yellow line.
Tony Stewart will be black flagged by NASCAR.
Okay,
black flag for Tony Stewart for going below the out-of-bounds line.
All clear, all clear.
And Tony Stewart is in second spot with $1 million on the line.
Okay, 27, but you're all clear, all clear.
Here comes Bobby Labonte. He's got $1 million on the line as well. It's Michael Waltrip who's pushing him toward the front.
And Labonte's underneath the yellow line on the backstretch.
This thing's not over yet. Michael Waltrip trying to become the first man to sweep a season at Daytona since 1982. He's up to third.
18-15 behind you. Three laps to go.
Ward Burton dives low.
Low, but you're clear.
I'll tell you one thing. If Junior was running three-quarter throttle, all that ended because he's running wide open right now.
Ward Burton rocketing toward the front. Look at him on the outside.
Behind you.
Outside of Michael Waltrip for third. Here's Elliott Sadler up to fifth. Where'd he come from in the Wood Brothers car?
Beats me.
Frantic, intense racing in the final laps at Daytona. But it's still Dale Earnhardt Jr. out in front. They've got to take the win away from him.
Tony Urie Jr.'s clapping, saying, come on, Junior, come on.
Two to go.
And Dale Earnhardt Jr. trying to block, trying to keep those cars behind him. Desperately trying to keep them behind him. He runs so good through the corner, he lets them get a run on him down the straightaway.
Michael Waltrip dives underneath Bobby Labonte. They bump on the backstretch. Waltrip to second. Elliott Sadler and Rusty Wallace with him. Race in the one and two positions.
That's who Dale needs to see in his rearview mirror right now. That's the best thing he can see.
Will Michael Waltrip block for Dale Jr.? Will he try to win the race himself? White flag is out. Final lap at Daytona. 180,000 on their feet, screaming wildly. 2.5 miles to go.
Just exactly the opposite of the Daytona 500. It was 15-8. Elliott Sadler is trying to keep Bobby Labonte behind. He can't do it. But he does move down in front of Rusty Wallace on that fast line.
All clear, all clear.
Bobby Labonte looking for some help, trying to get up there. His teammate Tony Stewart has never answered the black flag.
And they're four wide back between the Wallace boys.
Here they come, turn four, final lap of the Pepsi 400. Michael Waltrip in second, but it's going to be Dale Earnhardt Jr. using lessons learned from his father to go from sixth to first and score the victory with a Pepsi 400.
That's unbelievable.
Yes.
That man behind you did it for you.
Yes.
You guys celebrate. You love you, man. You did it.
That was beautiful. Very, very nice.
Junior, you're happy.
Look at that smile. Wow.
I don't think there's anybody here that didn't want to see that.
Sentimental favorite, emotional favorite. Earlier in the broadcast, we talked among ourselves. Some of the moves he made on the track today looked like his father behind the wheel.
I am
cheers.
Pretty cool.
Marty Snyder's on pit road with Tony Urie, Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s crew chief.
And you wouldn't believe the emotion, the tears out here for Dale Earnhardt Jr. If that wasn't like the old man, I don't know what was, Tony Sr.
I He had a good teacher. He told him a lot about this place. He loves this place. Hell, listen to them fans up there. They love that kid to death.
Saw you look to the heavens with a few laps to go. What did you say?
Well, he said he knew he could beat them. We just didn't know what was going to happen.
Remember when we've seen this before? Steve Mills joining the fray now.
Yeah, man, D.I.'s tough. D.I.'s tough.
We can celebrate.
What a finish at Daytona. Dale Jr. on top of the car in the infield.
The 1998 Daytona 500, when his father finally won the Great American Race, he threw the car into the grass doing victory donuts. Everybody joining in the celebration. That's Chocolate Myers. Long time crewman for Dale at Richard Childress Racing. Six to first in the final six laps. All right, Mikey, you celebrate too. You never got to celebrate your win in February. You celebrate now.
Man, that's just so cool. Storybook ending.
Oh, this is great. To Monte Carlo's reputation on the track is its reputation on the street. Monte Carlo, more champions depend on Chevy. He'll be there. To victory lane and Bill Weber. From certain people.
Yeah. Yeah. He was with me tonight. I don't know how I did it. But he was there. And Michael helped me. I guess we're even now.
You told Marty Snyder, Dale, you felt lonely on Father's Day. And there were times that you wanted to cry, but you couldn't. Did you cry tonight?
I'll be crying sooner or later. I don't know. I feel so good right now. I'm wore out there.
You know when your dad got his first win at Daytona? His first Winston Cup points win came 11 years ago today, July 7th, 1990.
I dedicate this win to him. I mean, there ain't nobody else that I could dedicate it to. that it would mean more to me. I want to say hey to Teresa back home. I hope she's loving it. We sure are. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Dale Earnhardt Jr. Now here comes Steve Park, his teammate who won at Rockingham after he lost Dale Earnhardt here. So the celebration here continues. Let's go to Matt.
And back in February, it was Michael Walter pushed the victory lane by Dale Earnhardt Jr. Did you pay back that favor tonight? Was that the game plan, Michael?
I just wanted Dale Jr. to win so bad, and I wanted to be a part of it. I didn't want to finish 10th or 12th. And the Napa Auto Parts Spirit of America hot rod was running. It was really fast. But I was committed to Dale Jr., just like he was to me in February. And I'll tell you when I really learned a lesson, when I was running third, protecting Dale Jr. and Rusty. And that's what Dale was doing in February. That's a handful. They were all over me, but I stayed committed. I wasn't about to bail out on them. And Dale Jr. called me on Monday morning after Daytona 500, and he said, I'm there for you, brother. And he was. And I just wanted to be part of it with him.
On top of the car, you two embraced, and then you were talking in each other's ears. What were you saying to each other?
This is what it's all about. We both were so excited about coming to Daytona. This place is a part of our lives. More so than any other place in the world. We weren't more emotional than normal. We were just normal, as normal as we can be since we lost our friend. But we were excited about racing, and then to have it end like that, it was cool being on top of the car with Dale Jr., but he's young, and they butt heads. I think I'm going to have a headache. Then he dove off the car, and I think I weigh more than everybody on my team, so I didn't want to hurt them or me. So I crept off and cruised over here. Thanks to Klausner Furniture, Ritz Crackers, Coca-Cola, Chevrolet, Goodyear Tires, and especially Napa Auto Parts, the greatest sponsor in NASCAR. Thank y'all.
A special night, a special victory for Dale Earnhardt Incorporated. Alan?
Dale Earnhardt Jr. becomes just the 38th driver in this track's long history to earn the right to go to victory lane and hold the Daytona Winner's Trophy. What a drive. What a performance.
I don't know. It kind of looks like he's kind of hesitant. You know, he said he can't trust me when I'm 16. He don't know if he's going to give me a call or wait because he can't trust me. He says I don't pay enough attention.
I know who wants to take me home.
A moment, Dale Earnhardt Jr. winning the Pepsi 400. Chocolate Myers, members of all the Dale Earnhardt Incorporated teams joining in. Michael Waltrip finally getting to celebrate his Daytona win with his close friend, Dale Earnhardt Jr. It's been quite a night here at the Daytona International Speedway, and we're only just beginning with our NASCAR coverage. As we take you on the road to the championship, things took a little bit of a shake tonight. Jeff Gordon's lead coming in was 126 points. He finished 37th. Dale Jarrett finished 13th, closing the lead to 54 as we head to Chicago next weekend.